What's up, you guys? My name is Aubrey and this is my channel, and today I'm gonna be talking about buying cars. You see, aside from the purchase of your house, a vehicle purchase is going to be one of the biggest purchases that somebody makes in their lifetime. It is a big purchase that needs to have a lot of thought put into it. Now, whenever we're discussing about buying cars, more often than not, the context of buying a car is always viewed as a depreciating asset, something that is an expense, never an investment that can grow. And though that is true, there are still ways that you can strategically purchase your vehicle to make it so that it costs you the most minimal amount as possible, if not in some cases, it can either break even or even make you money. So in this video, I'm going to be breaking down the top 10 cars that you can invest in and purchase in 2021. All of these cars are really safe financial bets if you're looking to buy a new vehicle. All of these cars are good vehicles that you could end up renting out on platforms like GetAround or Turo. And whether you're looking for a vehicle that can help make you some extra cash, or you're looking for one that won't depreciate like crazy, all of the ones in this top 10 list will be good options for you. So let's get started. Now, before we begin, I would like to preface that all of these 10 cars are in my personal opinion, and they're based off of a handful of different pieces of criteria. Number one, the cost of the vehicle. Number two, reliability and the ease of repairs for that vehicle. Number three, the depreciation rate of that vehicle. And number four, whether that vehicle can be used for personal use or if it can be used on platforms like GetAround, Turo, or even ride sharing services. So all of these are my opinion, and I'm sure that you guys will disagree with a lot of the ones that I've laid out, but all 10 of these are great investments regardless of what route you want to go down with your vehicle. Now with that, let's dig in to the top 10. So number 10 on this list is going to be a Toyota Prius. There really isn't any specific year that I had in mind for the Prius, but I would say probably between the years of 2007 and 2013. Now the Toyota Prius is a great car for a number of different reasons. Number one is the fact that it has great gas mileage. Number two is the fact that a Toyota Prius, specifically the year models of like 2007 to 2013, have hit their depreciation bottom. You can find a lot of these vehicles online for about $4,500 to about $65,000, $7,000. But you won't find them much lower than $4,500, even if they're a 2007 with 250,000 miles on it, which means that it is a great time to buy that vehicle. Now, when it comes to the Prius, why it's number 10 and not lower on this list is because of the fact that it does have some issues. Number one is the battery. If a battery goes bad on a Toyota Prius, it can cause a lot of major and very expensive issues. So that is something to be aware of and to be very cautious of if you're wanting to buy a Toyota Prius. Another reason why the Prius isn't higher up on this list is because of the fact that if you're somebody who's wanting to rent out a Prius on platforms like GetAround or Turo, there is a big issue with catalytic converters getting stolen on these cars. In fact, I've heard of this happening literally dozens, if not hundreds of times over my Turo career, and I've heard it happening with people who just own the cars and leave it outside of their house. This is something that is extremely common, and because of that, it sometimes can be a red flag if you're purchasing this car for the purpose of renting it out. But all in all, a Prius is a good investment for somebody who's wanting it to be their daily driver. It's also a really good bet if you're somebody who's wanting to use it in the gig economy. It gets great gas mileage, so you can use it to deliver services like Uber and DoorDash, and it's a really good car to have on GetAround as well as Turo. So because of that, this is number 10 on the list. Number 9 is a Jeep Wrangler, specifically a four-door Jeep Wrangler, and specifically not the newest model that recently came out, but the previous body style. So something like a 2010 to 2014 or 2015 would be really great options. Now there are a number of different reasons as to why I included the Jeep Wrangler on this list, even though I am personally not a fan of the Jeep. Number one is the fact that Jeeps hold their value incredibly, incredibly well. You could buy a 2011 or 2012 Jeep Wrangler for about $10,000 to $15,000. You could put on about 40, 50,000 miles on that car. You could own it for a handful of years, and you will lose very minimal amounts of money on that vehicle once you go to sell it. They hold their value like crazy, especially if you don't buy one new and you buy one used. The reason why I liked the model year of like 2010 to 2015 is because of the fact that they're old enough to have had depreciated by now, but they're not too old to where they are outdated. If you go with a model year like 2008, then you're looking at the outdated interior. It just becomes much more aged at that point, and the appeal is that much smaller. Another reason why I love the Jeep is because of the fact that Jeep has such a strong fan base. There will always be people out there that want to buy Jeeps, that want to rent Jeeps, and because of that, you have an audience audience that you can tap into if you're wanting to make extra money from your car. Jeeps do extremely well on Turo, so if you're wanting to get a car that you can not only enjoy, but also one that could potentially make you some extra money, a Jeep is a really good route to go down. Now, my one big complaint with the Jeep is the fact that I think they are personally too expensive for what you get. And I think that of the vehicles on this list, there are better values out there than the Jeep Wrangler. But you cannot deny the appeal that the Jeep has and the ability for it to hold its value and make you some extra money. And because of that, the Jeep Wrangler is number 9. Number 8 is my personal favorite car. It's a car that I love so much, and if this list was based purely on bias, it would be number 1 on the list. And that is a Toyota 4Runner. I love Toyota 4Runners. They are my favorite car by far. In fact, my very first car when I turned 16 was a 1997 Toyota 4Runner, and I am still driving that exact same Toyota 4Runner today in 2021. It's a 1997. It has 320,000 miles. I will keep that car until the day I die, and whenever I get a new daily driver, I will replace it with a newer Toyota 4Runner. I think as cars go, you can't get much better than a Toyota 4Runner. Now, here's why the 4Runner is included on this list and why it's not ranked higher. First, why it's included on the list. Toyotas hold their value incredibly, incredibly well. My 1997 Toyota 4Runner, which is an extremely well-kept vehicle but extremely high mileage, is a car that I could probably sell today for between $8,000 and $10,000. To think that you could sell a nearly 23, 24-year-old car for that price is absolutely crazy to think about. And there isn't many other cars you can say that about. Number 2 is the fact that Toyotas are extremely, extremely reliable. You see 1997, 1998, 2000-year models on the road all the time. And the same rings true for these newer year models. You see 2004, 2005, 2010, just all over the spectrum of model years for 4Runners driving on the road, still looking really strong. And the same cannot be said for many other car manufacturers out there. Similarly to a Jeep, a 4Runner does very well on the Turo platform. But I would say the big downside to the 4Runner is the cost of entry. And this is why it is not included higher on this list. From a business standpoint and from a cash flow standpoint, there are better vehicles out there than the Toyota 4Runner. But on the other hand, from a depreciation standpoint, there are very few vehicles out there that compare to the 4Runner. You could easily buy a used 4Runner today, put miles on it, drive it for a few years, and then sell it, and chances are you will break even, if not make some money, as long as you've taken care of the vehicle in the meantime. As far as depreciation goes, and as far as the return on investment goes, you can't get much better than a Toyota 4Runner, but it is lacking as far as making cash flow in the gig economy. Number 7 is the baby brother to the Toyota 4Runner, and that is the Toyota RAV4. Now, I also really like Toyota RAV4s, though I've never actually owned one. When it comes to a RAV4, there are a lot of the same benefits as the Toyota 4Runner. They hold their value extremely well, they have the Toyota brand, so they are extremely reliable, and they are also a bit more gig-friendly than the 4Runner. They're smaller, so they get better gas mileage. They aren't quite as cumbersome as the 4Runner is. I mean, the 4Runner is a large vehicle. And also, according to GetAround, a RAV4 is one of the top 10 best vehicles to rent out on the GetAround platform. RAV4s are quite a bit more affordable than a Toyota 4Runner, but they are still more expensive than similar vehicles with similar mileage and model year numbers. But you could get into like a 2010 to 2012 RAV4 for anywhere between $7,000 and $11,000, depending on the mileage and the overall condition of the vehicle. So it still is a fairly low-cost vehicle, especially in comparison to the depreciation of that vehicle. And when it comes to renting out a car like a RAV4 on platforms like GetAround or Turo, or even using it for rideshare, it really does kind of have the best of both worlds. It's large enough to where the vehicle can hold people, families, and you can run errands in the vehicle, but it's not too big to where it's overwhelming, which is sometimes the complaint that I hear with the 4Runner. Number 6 is the Scion, specifically the models XD and XB. Now, the reason why I like the Scion is because of the fact that it's basically a Toyota product. It is a Toyota product. So if you're looking for the reliability that comes with the Toyota, but you don't necessarily want the premium price tag that a Toyota name brings, then a Scion is a really great option. Now, the thing that I like about the Scion is the fact that you can get a really affordable, a very reliable car without necessarily sacrificing some of the luxuries that we've grown used to. For example, if you look at a base model Toyota or a base model Jeep, it is a base model, and whenever we say base, it is like base. There is manual locks, manual windows, cloth seats. There is no luxuries in those vehicles at all. But with the Scion, even the base model vehicles for Scion still have some of those creature comforts. They still have cruise control. They still have electric locks. They still have electric windows. And that is a big plus. Now, whenever we're looking at these types of Scions, the reason why I like them is because of the fact that they are small, but they are not too small. They sit multiple people, they have great gas mileage, and they are extremely affordable. For example, you could get a 2008-2009 Scion XD for about $4,000 to $5,000. And you could use that car to not only drive around on your own, but you could also rent it out on platforms like GetAround or Turo or a ride-sharing service. In fact, a Scion is a highly rated car on both GetAround and Turo, so if you were to invest in this type of vehicle, it would do well in those car sharing platforms. Now, when it comes to a Scion, there are some things that you should know. Number one is the fact that not all Scions are created equal. For example, there is a Scion TC, which is a two-door coupe, and that car is a car that I probably would not recommend because of the fact that a car like this is simply not a car that would do extremely well on a Turo or GetAround platform. Number two is a Scion IQ, which is essentially like the Scion equivalent of a smart car. In my opinion, I think that this car is way too niche-y and it's very, very small. And I think that the depreciation on this car is not as good as other Scion models. And the customer base you could reach on platforms like GetAround or Turo are simply too narrow. There are not enough people out there that want to rent a niche vehicle like a Scion IQ. Additionally, is the fact that some Scions are notoriously bad with their transmissions and engines. And you will want to make sure that you have done your due diligence to ensure that the car you are getting does not fall under those types of vehicles that have had those historical issues. So you will want to do some research. I don't think that the Scion is as no-brainer as some of the other cars that we've discussed on this list, but I do think that it is a good investment in the sense that it doesn't depreciate like some other cars out there. It is cheap to get into and they are reliable if you buy the right ones. Number five is the Ford Escape, specifically a Ford Escape with mile years of 2008 to 2011. The Ford Escape in a 2008 to 2011 year model is another one of those vehicles that I believe has hit a depreciation bottom. If you look at Ford Escapes online for purchase, you can find them that are 2008, 2009, 2010 with a wide variety of different mileage, and they are all sitting around that $4,000 to $5,000 price range, some a little bit higher than that, but not by much. This means that you could get into one of these vehicles, you could drive it, you could rent it out, you could put some wear and tear on them, and chances are you could probably sell that same vehicle for around the same amount of money. The Ford Escape is a great car that can fit families, it can fit groceries, you can drive it comfortably, but it's not too big, it doesn't take up too much gas, it is really accessible, and it's very affordable. Now, this car does extremely well on both Turo and GetAround. In fact, I have a Ford Escape that I've had for a couple of years now that I rent full-time on Turo, and it does very, very well. In my opinion, I think that the Ford Escape is kind of a nice balance between like an SUV, like a Jeep or a 4Runner, and some of these other smaller, more affordable cars that we'll mention later in this list. The Ford Escape is nice. It has the creature comforts that many people want, but it's not too expensive to where you're eating into your ROI. With the Ford Escape, you can buy it for about $4,500. You could rent it for anywhere between $30 and $40 per day, and that is a really, really great ROI. And if you choose not to rent it out, you can still drive it, put some wear on it, and then end up selling it for around the same price a few years down the line. In my opinion, I think that you cannot go wrong with buying a Ford Escape that is in the model year of 2008 to 2011, as long as you do your due diligence, you make sure that the car has a clean title, that it has been maintained, you'll be good to go. Number four is a Toyota Corolla. Now, I have to admit, I'm biased to Toyota products, if you haven't already noticed. I love Toyota products. I will live and die by Toyota products. And I think that they are really great vehicles to own, not only for personal use, but also for businesses like car sharing, Turo, and GetAround. And when it comes to Toyota Corolla, it's kind of the best of both worlds. It's more affordable than some of the other Toyota products that we've mentioned on this list, like a Toyota Prius, but it's not quite as bare bones as, let's say, a Toyota Yaris. Now, when it comes to Corollas, there are a handful of different reasons as to why I chose this to be number four on this list. Number one is the fact that Toyota Corollas hold their value, similar to other Toyota products. Now, when it comes to the Corolla, they're kind of the best of both worlds. They're not quite as expensive and they're not quite as nice as some of the other Toyota products that we've discussed on this list, but they also aren't quite as bare bones as, let's say, a Toyota Yaris, for example. They have the creature comforts of what many people want in a vehicle, but it's also affordable and it's also reliable. If you were to look for an older model Toyota Corolla, something like a 2008, 2009, in some cases even a 2007, you could expect to pay anywhere between $3,500 and $4,500 for that vehicle, depending on the mileage. And depending on the year, you could still rent that car out on platforms like GetAround or Turo. Now, both of these cars do well on car sharing platforms, and they are also good cars to drive around for day-to-day use. In some cases, you could purchase it at its depreciation bottom, which once again means that you could buy the car, drive the car, and then sell the car and potentially make a profit off of that sale. There's also a lot of Corollas available out there. This isn't like a niche car. It's very, quite honestly, a very bland, boring car. And because of that, there are a lot of options out there to choose from. So because of this, and because of the depreciation and the cost, as well as the reliability, the Corolla is marked as number 4 on this list. Number 3 is a Ford Fusion. Now, I really like the Ford Fusion. I have one in my Turo fleet and have had it for quite a long time now. Now, when it comes to a Ford Fusion, or really any Ford product in general, they aren't going to have the reliability of a Toyota product. And I've seen this firsthand with my own Turo fleet. They do have issues, but the good thing is that whenever those issues come up, they are typically pretty cheap to fix, especially if you're doing the labor yourself. Ford Fusions are more expensive than some other four-door Fords out there, but they are quite a bit nicer than other Ford models. For example, a Ford Focus. You could potentially buy like a 2011 Ford Fusion and spend about $4,500 on that vehicle. In fact, I bought a 2011 Ford Fusion about 2 years ago for $4,500, and I could sell that exact same Ford Fusion with higher mileage than when I bought it, and I probably could sell it for the same price of $4,500. An older model Ford Fusion in this year model range is at its depreciation bottom, which means it is a very good investment. It is a good investment to drive around on your own. They do very well on platforms like GetAround or Turo, and overall, they are just solid vehicles. They have the creature comforts that many people look for. They are comfortable to drive in. They aren't too small. They aren't too big, and they also have the Ford name, which isn't as reliable as some other brands, but they are cheap to fix, which is a huge plus side. In addition to all of these points, the Ford Fusion is readily available. If you look on Facebook, Craigslist, or eBay, you will find so many Ford Fusions to choose from. So it's not a matter of if you can find one, it's just a matter of choosing the right one for you or your Turo fleet. Number 2 on my list is number 2 for one reason and one reason only, and that is the cost and maintenance cost for these vehicles. And that is a Ford Focus. Specifically, Ford Focuses for model years of 2007 to 2011. Now, when it comes to a Ford Focus, they're kind of like a smaller version of a Ford Fusion, and they aren't quite as comfortable to drive as a Ford Fusion is, but they are significantly cheaper. In fact, you could find a 2007 Ford Focus today in 2021 for about $2,500. In fact, one of my Ford Focuses that I have in my Turo fleet, I purchased for just $2,300. When it comes to affordable, dirt cheap cars, Ford Focuses are one of the best ones out there. Now, more often than not, whenever you're looking for a Ford Focus on platforms like Craigslist or Facebook Marketplace, these cars are going to be in rough condition. They oftentimes have dings, dents, they oftentimes need some maintenance and some repairs done to them. And similar to our Ford Fusion, they aren't quite as reliable as a Toyota product, but they are very cheap to fix. In fact, you can buy all the parts that you need for a Ford Focus from places like Rock Auto or CarParts.com, and you could do most of the work yourself relatively easily by watching YouTube videos. So the fact is, even though Ford Focuses aren't as reliable and they do require more maintenance, the maintenance is very straightforward, it's easy, and it's extremely affordable. Now, when it comes to a Ford Focus, there are a handful of reasons as to why I chose it as number 2 on this list. And it's not because of the fact that it is a looker, because I will admit that these cars do look a bit outdated. But I will say that these cars are extremely available. There are so many different ones to choose from on platforms like Craigslist or Facebook Marketplace. They are cheap to fix, and in most cases, they have hit their depreciation bottom. You will not find a Ford Focus that is cheaper than $2,500, and in most cases, most of them range in that $3,500 range. But it is very normal to be able to find one of these cars for between $3,000 and $3,500. And a vehicle that can get you from point A to point B and that is easy to fix, a $3,000 price tag is a steal, especially if it's a car that you can go ahead and rent out on platforms like GetAround or Turo. Of all the cars that I've had in my Turo fleet, the Ford Focus is the one that I've had most often. I've had a lot of Ford Focuses over years, and I can say firsthand that these cars do well. They aren't the most luxurious, they are very simple, they are very basic, but they will get you from point A to point B. So whether you're wanting a Ford Focus for a fleet to make you some extra cash, or you're wanting one for your daily commute, you can't really go wrong with a simple car like the Ford Focus. And that brings us to number one, in my opinion, the best car to invest in 2021. And this is a car that I think many of you will disagree with, and that is the Toyota Yaris. Now, I love Toyota Yarises. If I didn't need a SUV in my life to transport my dogs, I would 100% daily drive a Toyota Yaris. I've had multiple Toyota Yarises in my fleet, and not only do I like renting these cars out from a business standpoint, I also like driving them. The Toyota Yaris is extremely simple. Most older models have manual locks, manual windows, and everything is just bare bones. No cruise control, nothing. But they are very, very easy to repair, and they are extremely, extremely reliable. Not only that, but they also get incredibly good gas mileage, and they are very easy to drive. Now, whenever it comes to driving vehicles, I've driven a lot over the years. Between my personal cars, my fiance's cars, my family's cars, as well as my Turo fleet, I've spent a lot of time in a lot of different cars. And not all cars are created equal as far as the ease of driving. Some cars have blind spots, some cars are hard to get used to, some cars are too low, some cars are too high. But when it comes to the Yaris, you can't get more simple than that. It's very, very simple to drive. There are very few blind spots. It is very easy to adjust to. You don't feel like you're in a small car, even though you are. And the car is surprisingly roomy for its size. Now, when it comes to a Yaris, if you were to get a model year of between a 2007 and a 2011, you would be able to find one at the depreciation bottom. Whenever I purchased my Yarises a couple of years ago, I purchased them between $3,500 and $4,500, depending on the car. And sitting here in 2021, I could sell that exact same car for that exact same price. Now, when it comes to Toyota Yarises, the price varies quite a bit depending on the model year. Like I said, you could get a 2007 to a 2011 for about $3,500 to $4,500. But if you're looking at newer models like 2013, 14, or 15, you probably will have to shell out between $8,000 and $9,000. Like most Toyota products out there, they hold their value quite well. And if you were to buy a 2009 model today, you could probably sell that same 2009 a few years down the road and not lose any money, and you could potentially make some money off of that sale. A Toyota Yaris is a great personal car because of the fact it has such good gas mileage and it's so reliable, and this is my favorite car for Turo and for get around. I think that they are great cars to rent out because of the fact that they are so affordable, they have such good reliability, and they are very easy to maintain. And whenever they do have issues, they are very, very cheap and easy to fix. And because of that, I think that the Toyota Yaris is the number one car to invest in 2021. Now, with that being said, you guys, again, these are just my personal choices for cars that I think are good investments. Of course, if you're looking for a dream car, or if you're looking for a car that you want to drive and you don't care about the business or investment aspect of it, you probably don't want to get a Toyota Yaris. I probably wouldn't blame you. But the fact is, whenever it comes to things like depreciation, reliability, and also the ability to make money off of that car, the 10 that I've laid out today are really great choices to look into. But they certainly aren't the only ones out there either, and I'm sure there are some of you that disagree with my choices, and I would love to hear your thoughts down below. So if you guys have any comments, if you have anything to add, if you have any questions, make sure to leave a comment down below. And while you guys are at it, make sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell. And I will see you guys in the next video.